أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق.
Recite in the name of your Lord who created.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقرأ. And now here you note, no salah, nothing of this home. Read. Ilm, the importance of knowledge. The knowledge that came to Muhammad was not through the worldly means of education. Allamahu shadidul quwa. Jibrail was the teacher. He taught him. In some traditions, Israfil remained with him for 3 years, teaching him. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Read in the name of your Lord who created.
خلق الإنسان من علق.
Created man from a clinging substance.
خلق الإنسان من علق. Created man from a blood clot. I've read this from this translation, but I don't agree with this translation now. This clot and blood clot has no connection with this root عين لام قاف. علق. معلقة. معلق ہو جانا. Something hanging. So it has denotes to that stage of embryonic development when it is like a leech attached to the wall of the womb of the mother, hanging with the, just as a leech attaches itself to your feet or your legs in the same way. So that was the stage, alaqa.
اقرأ وربك الأكرم.
Recite, and your Lord is the most generous.
اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Read, and your Lord is most bountiful.
الذي علم بالقلم.
Who taught by the pen.
الذي علم بالقلم. Who has taught by the pen. What does it mean? The human knowledge, the acquired human knowledge, has been transmitted from one generation to the other through pen. One generation gathers the knowledge, puts it down to writing, it is transferred to the next generation. This way, this acquired human knowledge, this scientific knowledge, this is going up every day.
عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ.
Taught man that which he knew not.
عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. He taught man what he knew not. After this, 5 ayat, now 3 ayat, which I think I have already explained. A person whose own moral, you know, consciousness is very active and living and vibrating, and when he sees to the people, what they are doing, where are they going, what has happened to them? A thinker, a philosopher, in response to what Suratul Teen came, yes, your observation is correct. They have gone down, very much down, down, down. But they were not created at that level.
كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى.
No, but indeed, man transgresses.
كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى. Nay, man surely transgresses the limits. You are doing something wrong to your brother, treating wrongly your neighbor, not respecting and serving your parents. You are stealing, you are killing, you are making a nation slave to you. The colonial rule, verily, the man does transgress. Your observation is not wrong. What you have seen is correct. But what is the reason?
Because he sees himself self-sufficient.
Because man feels and sees himself, he is not questioned, he is not punished, he is not rewarded. I did this thing wrong to him, nothing happened to me. I ate the wealth of the orphan. No cancer to my stomach, not even a blister to my mouth. Nothing has happened. This world is incomplete regarding the moral law. It is complete regarding the physical law. If you take poison, you will die. This is the physical law. If you put your hand in the fire, it will be burnt. This is physical law. But when you tell a lie, no blister on your tongue. If you have usurped the wealth of others, nothing will come to you. So this world where these things are not rewarded, the servants of humanity not rewarded, mostly they were tortured. What happened to the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Were they honored? No. So morally speaking, this world is incomplete. It will be complete only in the hereafter, when the moral results will come fully and become manifest. كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيْطَغَى رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى
إِنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الرُّجْعَى.
Indeed, to your Lord is the return.
إِنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الرُّجْعَى. Verily, to your Lord is the return. On returning, every human soul will be recompensed fully. And secondly, this is the guidance. If you want to make this society of yours healthy and good and just, tell people that they have to return to their Lord and face the grand accountability of the Day of Judgment. This is the only remedy. No justice can be established here. No fair deal will ever come here. No just order can ever be established here unless people come to know and believe, and they have conviction that they will be resurrected and they will have to stand before their Lord on the Day of Judgment, and then they will have to bear the consequences of what they are doing today. Inna ila rabbika ruj'a. This is the only remedy. Now in the rest of the ayat of this surah, in the background is the person of Abu Jahl. I told you Abu Jahl was, in a way, not very bad man, not from amongst the worst people of Mecca. He had some good qualities. When he was asked, do you think that Muhammad is telling lies? And no, he never told a lie. Then why don't you accept him? No, there was a competition between us and the Banu Hashim. They entertained people in feasts. They fed the poor people. We did more than them. So the competition was going on this thing. Up till now, we are going shoulder to shoulder with them. They have not been able to outdo us. But now if we accept Muhammad as messenger of Allah, we shall have to accept slavery for all time to come. And this I am not ready to accept. So give the devil his due. He said it plainly. And he was not a miser, as I told you. Amma man bakhila, that was not in him. But istaghna and kazaba bil husna, both were there. But had he accepted Islam, what would he have become? Can you imagine? He would have been the second Umar, radiallahu anhu. The traits of the character of Umar and Abu Jahl were the same. Same courageousness, same steadfastness. All these things were there, common. And that is why the Prophet had presented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala these two persons. Allahumma ansur al-Islam. O my Lord, help Islam, strengthen Islam. By the Islam of one of these two people at least, either Umar ibn al-Khattab or Amr ibn Hisham, it was the name of Abu Jahl. Equal. Character states the same. But Allah selected Umar, that's why. But it was his lot, and he was rejected. Good it would have been. But he has adopted the other career.
أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى.
Have you seen the one who forbids?
عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى.
A servant when he prays.
أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَانَ عَلَى الْهُدَى.
Have you seen if he is upon guidance?
أَوْ أَمَرَ بِالتَّقْوَى.
Or enjoins righteousness?
أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى.
Have you seen if he denies and turns away?
أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى. Have you considered if he has belied and turned his back?
أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى.
Does he not know that Allah sees?
أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. Doesn't he know that Allah is seeing him? And note it. He always called upon Allah. Never لا تزا etc. etc.
أَلَّا لَئِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِ لَنَسْفَعًا بِالنَّاصِيَةِ.
No, if he does not desist, we will surely drag him by the forelock.
نَاصِيَةٍ كَاذِبَةٍ خَاطِئَةٍ.
A lying, sinning forelock.
فَلْيَدْعُ نَادِيَةٍ.
Then let him call his associates.
سَنَدْعُ الزَّبَانِيَةِ.
We will call the angels of hell.
كَلَّا لَا تُطِعْهُ وَاسْجُدْ وَاقْتَرِبْ.
No, do not obey him, but prostrate and draw near to Allah.